Bada bing, bada boom, it's your boy, Seth Limbo. Okay, today we're going to go over quite possibly one of the craziest conspiracies things in history, and it has to do with your boy, Charlemagne, that piece of shit. Anyway, Charlemagne had a son, quote, hashtag, quote unquote, whatever, named Pepin the Hunchback, which I don't know how you get that name anyway. By now he should be known by his name, not just Charlemagne. Like, what the fuck is that? Pippin the Hunchback, not Pippin, Pepin, I'm not trying to correlate hobbits and this, not at all. Anyway, I'm coming up with the theory that Pepin the Hunchback was not actually his name or any of that stuff. I think he was, because Charlemagne was a pervert, and he had many concubines, and two of his children were, what do you call it, bastards. So, honestly, it's all hearsay at this point. It's so old. But here's my theory. I think Pepin the Hunchback was Charlemagne's, his prostitute or concubine. I think he had a gay relationship with him. I wouldn't put it past Charlemagne. He's a fucking pervert. And he killed his brother. So, honestly, everything's hearsay at this point. So, that's where we're going to go from there. Honestly, this might be the first case of a trans person, because he could have been trans, too. He could have been Pepin the Hunchback, a.k.a. first, like, I don't know, Charlemagne is a crazy fox. You never know what Charlemagne's into. He could have been into that. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but he could have been into it. And there's just a lot of things in history that weren't covered, and there's a lot of information that I have that everything leads up to Pepin the Hunchback being a concubine, a male concubine with Charlemagne. And I think to save face, because everybody's like, why are you with this little hunchback dude all the time? And we're hearing loud noises in the rooms and stuff, and his wife was mad, because, I mean, why would you have two bastards if you have a wife? Like, apparently he couldn't get it up with his wife because he had a fetish for his son, a.k.a. Hunchback, because I think he had, like, a weird fetish for that thing. Plus, in the picture, he's got something wrong with his balls, so maybe, like, maybe he had some special abilities back then that, like, they thought that was in some way connected to God. You never know. See, that's the thing. I'm not trying to say this happened. I just want to open a dialogue about what could have possibly happened now. That's what I'm covering. See, Pepin. It can be pronounced Pippin. Okay, so Pippin der Bucklege, whatever the fuck that means. He was apparently humpback, and I think to save face, he just got rid of him. But he lived to be 42, so I mean, he had some form of life. You wouldn't keep a hunchback back then. That would be like some type of like ungodly creature, and they would have thrown him out. There's no way he lived to be 42. So that's why I'm dead set. He had to have been some type of lover, some type of thing. I don't know. I can go on and on. And honestly, I'll be making more videos about this topic, because I really like the Frankish history, because I think they're all a bunch of perverts, because, I mean, look at France now, it's fucked. So, honestly, I'm just trying to open a historical dialogue on maybe that Pepin the Hunchback was a gay prostitute, possibly. He's either that, or he was a hunchback, and bottom line is, I'm trying to just open up a dialogue on how much of a fucking douchebag Charlemagne was. Charlemagne fucked his brother, not literally, like, you got fucked. He did not fuck Charlemagne. He may have fucked Pepin, but Charlemagne, he fucked him, like, it's a matter of speech. Charlemagne got fucked every fucking year of his life, and he died at 20 because he was murdered on the order of Charlemagne. I can't prove it, but you can't really prove anything back then because the documents were shit and they barely could read. So, honestly, I'm opening up a dialogue. If anybody's interested, I want to talk about this, because this could be the first trans LGBTQ person who got completely destroyed in history. This could be the smoking gun to start off this whole thing, and then it has to do with Christianity, too, because they're all Christians, and you know, some Christians, not all, but some, are pedophiles, and maybe Pepin wasn't his son. He was a bastard anyway. You can't prove anything. The concubine that have him might not even have been Charlemagne's. History can be can be changed, however it's written by the victor. As you can see with Carloman, Carloman got shit on. Who knows, maybe he didn't get shit on. Maybe that's just how history wrote it.